Reactions that take place when the human body is put under a hypnotic encounter. These reactions lead us to the question, to what extent hypnosis can cause shifts in the brain's perception, developing unconscious inferences without the consent of the body? Good morning, my name is Carla Colon. You may ask yourself, why is this important? Well, as presented by Richard Axel in his article, Sense and Sensibility, A Molecular Logic of Olfactory Perception, through the five senses, the human brain gathers information from the environment and then creates its own unique and internal representation of what they observe in the external world. Sometimes these circumstances can lead to distractions or situations that can affect many people's mentality. Therefore, with the presentation of the benefits that hypnotherapy can bring to the human body, people might be more willing to adopt this practice and find a cure to the psychological problem that might be affecting them. As shown in the video, the body responses of the lady simulated that she was continually becoming unconscious and eventually unaware of the way her body was reacting. These reactions can occur as a hypnotherapist gently guides a person into a trance where he is better able to communicate with the subconscious mind of the subject. According to the experts, Scott O'Lilienfeld and Hal Akowitz, the authors of the article, is hypnosis a distinct form of consciousness? It's a shift toward heightened activity in the theta band and an increment in the operation of the brain's anterior cingulate cortex takes place under hypnotic encounter. These mental manipulations are associated with a state of quiet concentration, which is the response mostly seen throughout the whole process of hypnosis. According to the study, Brain States and Hypnosis Research by Michael A. Pastner and Mary K. Rothbard, when a person is in a state of hypnosis, it induces greater reliance on the oriented network rather than the executive network as a means of control over behavior. This means that a control exerted by the oriented network would lead the susceptible person to be under the influence of external control. As shown in this image, when a person is in a state of hypnosis, it is seen how the oriented network is more active than the executive network, meaning that external factors are having more control over the individual than the internal factors in the individual itself. For example, even though a person have to go under an unconscious state and exposed to the external factors, the both effects of hypnosis seem to be very beneficial for the human body. Hypnosis can expand the human brain and facilitate the view of more perspectives. For example, in this image, do you see a duck or a rabbit? Just as this optical illusion is a trick put in your mind where you can visually perceive two different images in one, hypnosis can work the same way. By expanding your brain to more views or perceptions than you will be able to have in a normal state of mind. In addition to expanding your perceptions, hypnosis can also develop what is called posthypnotic suggestions, which are the positive suggestions given to a person that is under the state of hypnosis but that are intended to successfully take effect after the person emerges from the trance and is no longer under hypnosis. In addition to these post-hypnotic suggestions, hypnosis can also serve as a useful medical tool, since it can help in the breaking of bad habits, overcoming insomnia, recalling forgotten experiences, and as an anesthetic for managing pain. As shown in this graph by the association Elevate Hypnotherapy, it is shown how hypnotherapy allows patients a better improvement of their quality of life, both in short and long terms, than supportive therapy does. In conclusion, even though hypnosis might seem like a strange practice that can do unusual things like cause shifts in the brain's perception and develop unconscious inferences without the consent of the body, its both effects seem to be very beneficial for the human body. Therefore, I propose a solution that hypnosis becomes more recognized and practiced among the societies, and that through its practice, a cure to the many psychological disorders affecting humans is found. However, we have to consider that everyone's body is different, and that even highly hypnotizable people may not benefit from this practice or obtain the medical impacts desired. Also, we have to consider that a single session of hypnosis might not produce lasting results. Therefore, the patient will have to undergo a series of hypnotic procedures to reinforce the constructive suggestions that may be given during the hypnotic process. Thank you.
All right, thank you. I do have two questions for you. What was there evidence that you gathered that you didn't use, and if so, why didn't you use it?
So some evidence I gathered was about how hypnosis is used for the medical tool and how it has evolved to become a medical practice, but I decided not to use that because I wanted to focus my research more on the psychological and perspective of hypnosis and how hypnosis is able to manipulate the brain and cause reactions in the body.
Okay. Then one more question. If you had more time, what additional research would you conduct related to this issue?
If I had more time, I would have done more research on the history of hypnosis, like where it was first practiced and who were the first people, the first hypnotherapy in the world.
Okay, thank you.